Welcome to Adelaide, the capital city of South Australia. A city which is known for its rich heritage, culture, food, and obviously internationally famous wineries. And the only city in Australia which is not built by the convicts but the free settlers. So let's see for the next 5 days how much Adelaide and what parts of South Australia we can cover. So stay tuned and enjoy this virtual trip with us to a new city in Australia. And do like, comment and subscribe to our channel and share your thoughts in the comment section. So let's get started. Hey guys, good morning. What's up? I'm Ananya and with me Milan, and we both welcome you all to our travel channel, Milan, the travel freak born couple. So it's 5:30 a.m. on Sunday morning and we are off to Adelaide. So seems like it's been ages. Last year we took a flight to Cassie and since then we had to cancel 3 flights because of this COVID situation, and finally we are going to Adelaide. So the second to Adelaide flight trip is around 2 hours, and because of some COVID restrictions, you have to complete a cross-border travel form that we did 10 days before, and we have got the approval as well. So all set and go. And we are ready to board the flight. So we'll see you there at the Adelaide Airport. Let's go.
The best part of flying in the morning is not only that flights are cheaper and are less likely to be delayed, but also it's a great way to experience the gorgeous dawn creeping into the Sydney sky, a boiling red sunrise over you amidst clouds, and an entire day in your pocket to explore the place with the excitement of watching a new city from a bird's eye view. It took us only 2 hours to reach from Sydney to Adelaide, and the first view of the vast blue water will undoubtedly make you super excited about the city.
So once you are coming to South Australia, once you land, you have to declare that you haven't been to the overseas for the last 14 days, and you have to check in with the MySA Gov, and where the police will take all the details when you're arriving at Adelaide, and if anything goes wrong, all the details will be there and you will be contacted. So as of now, everything seems to be good, so we are heading to the rental car.
We had booked our rental car online and they offered us a free pickup service from airport to their office in the city, from where we would be getting the car for the next 5 days.
Yes, right now we will be taking the car and we'll go to our hotel, and from there we'll start the rest of our trip.
Adelaide is South Australia's cosmopolitan coastal capital, the state's largest city and the 5th most populous city of Australia, with a population of around 1.5 million people located on the coast at the very bottom of Australia. This city is known for few things: the city of churches, its excellent cultural heritage and thriving food and wine culture. Besides that, it is also the greenest city in Australia, with its city centre surrounded by the parklands. Venture to the North Terrace, one of Adelaide's most famous tree-lined boulevards. Here you will discover the Art Gallery and the State Library of South Australia, and the famous South Australian Museum, where you can easily spend hours browsing the unique collection of Australian, Aboriginal and European art. The must visit place is the Museum of South Australia, which houses an impressive dinosaur and the whale section, which amazes everyone. Adelaide CBD is compact and divided into a very logical grid system featuring streets that run at right angles to each other, surrounded by gardens and parks. The city can easily be explored on foot. However, if you prefer, you can rent these bikes or take the free tram between the spots. These orange and purple mobile bikes are found at every street in the city, and it operates based on a mobile app called Beam, featured by online payment, which charges you 30 cents per minute. Staying anywhere within the city is very convenient, as pretty much everything is walkable, and it is the most convenient place for catching public transport. We were lucky enough to have our Airbnb right next to the city center, and we could traverse the city anytime we wanted. Whether you are looking to soak up the sun at one of Adelaide's pristine beaches or go for a wine tour in the Adelaide Hills, Adelaide has a little bit of everything for everyone.
We are here at the Parliament of South Australia and it's open for the general public. So let's see what's there inside.
As you walk along the corner of North Terrace and the King William Road in the Adelaide City Centre, you will reach the seat of the Parliament of South Australia, where you might get a lifetime chance of witnessing the live session, which we were lucky enough to experience. As you walk past the Adelaide Railway Station and explore the various corners of the city, you will come across quirky shops, trendy cafes, pubs with live music and good restaurants. Adelaide is known for shopping, so don't miss out to stop at Australia's most famous Heritage Hikes chocolate shop. They are famous for making fine chocolates in Australia since 1915.
Once you come to a chocolate factory, you just can't resist yourself from buying chocolates.
Victoria Square is a central square in the Adelaide City Centre and is home to some of the city's most prestigious buildings. It sits at the centre of Adelaide's grid-like structure and is bordered by a number of important edifices.
We are here at the heart of the Adelaide City, and at this particular place, you can see all the major buildings that the city has to offer. And the best part of the Adelaide City is, it has a good mix of old heritage buildings as well as the modern buildings.
One of the absolute favorite things about Adelaide is that it's a very green city. Taking a tour of Adelaide with a walk down to the River Torrens around Adelaide Convention Center, admiring the pretty views and doing a bit of people watching is a wonderful experience.
We took a tram from the Victoria Square and have come here at the Adelaide Center, and now we are heading to the Adelaide Oval to have a trip there. Let's go.
You will also see the famous Adelaide paddle boats here, and you can take one for a paddle if you are game.
So we are here at the Adelaide Convention Center, right next to the River Torrens that runs throughout the Adelaide City. This city vibe gives me a similar kind of feel like the Melbourne one, where the River Yarra runs across the city.
So here we are at the most exciting part of our city trip. The Adelaide Oval is one of the most picturesque sporting grounds in the world. Born 150 years ago in 1871 after the formation of the South Australian Cricket Association, this had always been a South Australian icon.
No Adelaide city trip is complete without taking a tour at the Oval. We are here right next to the South Gate, waiting to witness the magic and the history inside. So to take a tour at the Oval, you have to book an online ticket, which is $25 per person, and it takes regularly around 10, 11 and 2 p.m. So let's see what's there inside.
If you want to learn more about this iconic stadium, you can embark on a journey into the inner sanctum of the Adelaide Oval, led by expert volunteer guides. Go behind the closed doors as you are told captivating stories, shown hidden secrets, stand inside the historic century-old scoreboard and relive the celebrated moments.
6 to go, 9, 8, 7, 6, put number 6 on the nail, and now it's pointing to bowler number 6. There's the technicality. This is the 1970s version.
It was one of the amazing guided tour we had, and trust me, we enjoyed so much.
A 1.5 hour trip full of information and full of experience.
After exploring Oval, we went on to the amazing Central Market, which is Southern Hemisphere's largest undercover market.
We are here at the Adelaide Central Market, which is a favorite shopping destination and one of the oldest indoor markets in the world.
Here you can discover an amazing range of different stalls selling fresh produce, flowers, cheeses, spreads and more. Primarily, this is one of Australia's top fresh food markets. It has become a tourist destination thanks to the bright, lively atmosphere and the amazing choice of food to be found here.
So guys, today we are here at Central Market in Adelaide, And as a first-time traveler, it's really hard to understand where to go, because this place is just like a spider web.
Exactly.
There's so many shops to look around.
The Adelaide Market is an institution and probably one of the best among all Adelaide attractions. A colorful place filled with great atmosphere and an authentic celebration of local produce and cuisine. From homegrown fruits, vegetables, native meats, cheese, bread to an array of local seasonal delicacies. This kangaroo meat shop is one of the hyped shops in the market, where they sell fresh kangaroo meat. So all the meat lovers flock to this place to have their variety. In a way, you will love browsing through the stalls here, enjoying coffee, breakfast and lunch. On Saturdays, there are food tastings as well, with stalls and shops offering free tastings of the local produce.
So we just came out from the Adelaide Central Market and are planning to explore the city by walking along the streets.
What they have done in here over the city areas, it's more or less, it's all about a 1p and it's cost you like $4. So you can pretty much get parking anywhere. Just make sure you're parked in the right spot. Otherwise, the fines are really quite expensive in here in Adelaide.
So on our city exploration trail, our next destination is the Adelaide Botanical Garden.
Adelaide Botanic Garden is an oasis in the cosmopolitan heart of the city, featuring beautifully landscaped gardens, majestic avenues and stunning architecture.
When we went to the Hunter Valley during the summer season of January, the grapes were all in full bloom. And now here, we can actually see the dry grapes.
Spanning 50 hectares, this historic garden, which opened in 1857, features some of the Australia's finest plant collections filled with indigenous plants, flowers and shrubs. This place is perfect to wander and stop and enjoy the peace and quietness within the city.
Now we have come to the star attraction of this Adelaide Botanical Garden. They say that there is a surprise element inside it. Let's check that out. Oh wow, indeed it is. This entire zone has been transplanted into a rainforest, so you will feel that you are actually entering a rainforest zone. So we are done with our rainforest walking trail, and it's an absolute treat to the eyes.
So enjoy your walk in this Adelaide Botanic Garden, soaking up the nature's finest greenery. It is indeed a lovely spot to relax right in the middle of the city.
This abode of greenery will give you enough oxygen to complete the rest of your trip. So we are done with this botanical garden tour, and now we will head on to the shopping destination of the Rundle Mall. So it's 5 p.m. in the evening and we are here at the Rundle Street, the main shopping hub of the Adelaide City.
Rundle Mall is a place like the one where you shop till you drop. The famous Rundle Place ball sits in the middle, which is the best photo opportunity in Adelaide. Rundle Mall is Adelaide's famous pedestrian-only shopping hub. Take a relaxing walk in the city heart by either window shopping or watching people. The Rundle Mall is the best place to hang out.
Every city has its own market. We have already seen the Melbourne and the Sydney one, and now it's time to see what the Adelaide market has in store for us. This particular building always gives you a beautiful architecture feel. So it's so colorful and good to see.
Go for a wander along the Adelaide Arcade for more independent boutique stores. Rundle Street East is the heart of Adelaide's cosmopolitan East End district and just a stone's throw from the Crown Plaza, Adelaide. So whether you are looking to clothes shop at Alana Hill or shop around for homewares and gifts, Rundle Street has a diverse mix of fashion and retail to meet your every need.
This place is indeed a shopper's paradise. you will literally get so many shopping options that you have to think which way you want to go and from where you want to shop. So since it's already evening, it's almost 5:30 and it's going to close soon, so we have decided we have to come another day to do a proper shopping.
With global brands and local favorites, Randall Mall is the longest and one of the busiest malls in Australia, where more than 400,000 locals and tourists visit the mall each week to enjoy their shopping, dining and entertainment from over 700 retailers and 300 services.
So we are back at square one from where we started our day. It has been a fantastic day because whatever we had in our itinerary, we almost ticked up all the places. And obviously, the best was the Adelaide Oval Tour. So right now, it's 7 p.m. in Avery. We started our day at 9 a.m. Hopefully, you are enjoying this virtual tour of Adelaide City with us. If so, do not forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe our channel. We will see you all at the next episode with a new destination. Till then, stay tuned and take care.